Hello everyone, good afternoon. Today we'll start with metallurgy. Okay, I want to finish this chapter today itself. Okay, that's why I'm taking this up. Okay, so we'll do it now, metallurgy, so that you'll have some idea for your coming exam. Right, peace, cool. So see, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is metallurgy. In metallurgy, metallurgy, we'll basically talk about ores and the extraction of metals. Okay, what are the process for extraction of metals we have, right? And what are the ores we have for different metals? What ores we use for the extraction of one particular metal? Okay, so basically, the process that we use for extraction of any metal, that process we have to consider, and we'll have to consider various factors into this. Obviously, we have to consider the percentage content of that metal which we are going to extract. Okay, what is the percentage content of that metal in that ore? That is one priority we should give. Another priority is what? The like economically, the process is feasible or not. Suppose you are extracting one particular metal, and there are n number of ways possible, 5-10 different ways possible for extraction of one particular metal, right? But the process which is most favorable economically, that process we are going to use in the practical way. Right? So right. The point is so that's how it is, right? We have to consider all the factors which is useful for the extraction of any metal. For extraction of one metal, if you are putting so much of money, there's no point doing that particular method. Okay, using that particular method. Okay, so that's how the chapter is all about, right? Like I said, there are different process we have for extraction. The process that we choose, that also depends upon the property of the metal, right? That we are going to extract, right? So all those different process we'll discuss. Okay, but first of all, let me tell you, this chapter will have two different portions. In this chapter we have, the first one is, like I said, extraction of metals. And we'll also see making of alloys. Okay, two different terms that we use here. The first one is minerals, and the second one is ores. Minerals and ores, O-R-E-S. What are minerals? These are the compounds. Write down this definition. These are the compounds which are available naturally in the earth crust and can be obtained by mining we call it as minerals. Now ores are what? Ores are basically minerals only, right? So these are the minerals These are the minerals from which a metal can be extracted economically and conveniently, easily and with less amount of money we need to put, and we can extract the metals, right? So ores are nothing but minerals, okay? So what we can say here, all ores, if you see the two statement, we can say, hence, all ores are minerals, but all minerals, are not ores. This we can say. For example, if I give you one example here, FeS2, the name of this is what? Iron pyrite. FeS2 iron pyrite. Okay. Iron pyrite is a mineral not ore, because the production of iron from iron pyrite requires heavy cost, very high cost requires for this production. Okay. That's why this is a mineral, not ores. We won't use iron pyrite for the extraction of iron. Okay. Copy it down. Okay. Done. Can I go to the next page? Let me know. Okay. Like this, we have, there are few names or the molecular formula of ores you need to memorize. Okay. So write down the heading here. Some examples of ores. Right? These examples also they ask in exam. Okay, not in JEE, but other competitive exams. Okay, they ask these questions. Okay, like for example, the first one, if I write here, it is ZnO, zinc oxide. We also call it as zincite. The name of this compound is zincite. This you have to memorize. Fe2O3. Oxides of iron, Fe2O3, we call it as hematite. Copy it down, all of you. Fe304, it is magnetite. MnO2. MnO2 is pyrolusite. SnO2. We call it as cassiterite. CASSETERITE. Cassiterite. Or we also call it as tin stone. Sixth one, U3O8, not that important. We call it as pinch blende. Sorry, pitch blende, BLENDE. AL2O3.3H2O. We call it as bauxite. Important. The next one is PBS, lead sulfide. PBS. We also call it as lead sulfide, and we also call it as galena. HGS. It is cinnabar. Okay. 10th one. Cinnabar. FeS2. We call it as fool's gold. This question they have asked in exam. Fool's gold. It looks like gold. Golden, like golden in color. That's why we call it a fool's gold. Ag2s. It's argentite. ZnS. It is zinc blend. We also call it as sphalerite. CuFeS2. It is copper pyrite. Or we also call it as chalcopyrite. Okay. Next one is NaKNO3. Indian saltpeter. Fifteenth one, NaNO3. It is Chile saltpeter. TTER. Here it is. AgCl is horn silver. Many times they have asked this question. It is horn silver. Na3AlF6. Cryolite. 4-5 more we have copied down first. Here I'll write down one. KCl. KCl is silvine. Let me know once you are done. Okay, yeah. Next, you see, CaF2 is fluorspar. MgCO3 is magnesite. MgCO3 is magnesite. FeCO3, carbonate, all this we have. FeCO3 is siderite. The last two, ZnCO3, is calamine. CaCO3 dot MgCO3. It is dolomite. See, these are the few examples of ores. See, out of all these, there are few, you know, ores which are important, which you must remember. Like, all these are important. 23rd one, 22nd one, fluorspar, this one. Siderite is not that much important. And if I go in the last page, here we have jensite important, pyrolusite, pitch blende is important. Cinnabar, FES2, AGCL, CUF. At least this much you must remember. All these formula of ores. Okay.